performing on stage is like a wave of electricity. It just starts at my toes and it runs all the way up through. It's almost like an out-of-body experience. Like I can almost watch myself from the other side of the lens. Almost impossible to explain, but I have a ton of fun when I do it, and I think it definitely translates to what people see. I've always been, like, music's always been a huge part of my life. I grew up listening to my dad play music, and just watching him on stage was always really cool. I've been involved in dance and theater since I was a kid. So it just kind of, the performing aspect, it just kind of runs through my veins. I love being on stage. I love different personas and the different characters I can play around with. And now that I found the live music scene, I get to play with both the music side and the theater side, which is a lot of fun. My favorite groups and people that I love to listen to are the Beatles. I've been listening to a lot recently. Simon and Garfunkel, especially Paul Simon's insane songwriting skills. And then recently I've come back across to like Coldplay and Rob Thomas. I've listened to Aerosmith. I've had a whole like 80s and 70s hair band phase that I think all just kind of influences what I do now. Yeah.
me is what makes this so. It's nice to know you're there for me. Yeah, it's nice to know our love will always be. It's nice to know you'll be the one I come home to when my day is done. Your love for me is what makes it so. David played and it pleased the Lord, but you don't really care for music, do you? Well, it goes like this, the fourth, the fifth, the minor fall, the major lift, baffled king composing, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Faith was strong, but you needed proof. You saw her bathing on the roof. Her beauty in the moonlight overthrew you. She tied you to a kitchen chair, broke your throne, and she cut your hair. And from your lips she drew the hallelujah. Hallelujah. Maybe there's a God above, but all I've ever learned from love was how to shoot somebody who outdrew you. It's not a cry that you hear.